merciful Father, I have squandered my days with plans of many things. This was not among them. But at this moment, I beg only to live the next few minutes well.
When the time comes, don't let them be taken.
For all we ought to have thought, we have not thought. All we ought to have said, have not said. All we ought to have done, we have not done. I pray thee, God, for forgiveness.
Do I see my mother and my sisters and my brothers? Though that do I see the line of
my people back to the beginning?
They do call to me.
They bid me take my place among them.
Your halls of Valhalla,
where the brave
may live
forever.
Hey guys, Jason here. Yeah, football game is going on. so you know, catch me looking at that way, my TV there. But what I want to talk about today is, like, you know, I watch these videos, you know, like the rapture cultists, you know, the experts, you know, the know-it-alls, you know, and it's all about what they think, and, you know, and Jesus loves them, and Jesus loves, you know, and all that crap. Well, they don't have no evidence, but they keep failing every day. I don't know why they keep doing it. Well, you know why we do it, you know, or why they do it is because it's about the money. I don't know how much money they make, like, especially old Cheech here, you know. You know, he he posts the date there, August 2nd, 2027. Okay, let me tell you something about that number. It's 8-2, right? So August is the 8th month. So 8-2, that's my birthday, guys. August 2nd. If people were listening to what I was saying, they would actually know, like, what's actually going on, right? Like, there's going to be an eclipse happening in just coming up in America. I don't hear nobody talking about that yet because they don't know these things. They're just guessing, I guess, right? So you look at even the number 2027. You know, 27 is like, just eliminate the 20, right? 27, flip it around, is 7-11. Jason, right? So what I've been trying to show people, right, is who this person Jason is. You know, it so happens my name's Jason, you know. My name's in the Bible, last name too, Campo, right? I don't know if anybody ever paid attention to that. Campo, C-A-M-P-E-A-U. You know, people should know that E-A-U, if you look at your water bottle, that's what water stands for. So I found that my last name in 2019, right? And guess what? Guess what falls on Deuteronomy 23:11? Thanksgiving, American Thanksgiving. You think they would catch on to that? But that's what I said. They don't. The Bible is quite clear saying that they all ignore God. They all hate God. Like, it's throughout the Bible. I've been trying to show people that. This is why they have nothing to do with God. This is why they're waiting for Jesus to show up. And what they don't understand is, Jesus died and he went to the Father. Well, who do you think the Father is? I'm trying to show you who he is. But you guys don't want to listen to me. It just doesn't make sense. So, I have no clue. I don't know how to get through to them, you know. I don't know. I could throw all this scripture, all this biblical evidence in people's faces, but they'll still refuse it. That's why Zechariah 7:11, you know, 7:11 is quite clear. They didn't hearken unto my words. So, you know, because they have to get, this has to be fulfilled, right? There's going to be those that do, that have been chosen, right? And then there's going to be some that are just going to leave, right? It happened the same thing with Jesus, right? His disciples left him, right? Because Jesus was telling another story to what the disciples were understood. You have to remember the disciples were in the Jewish doctrine, which was they were following the Messiah and Christ doctrine. Jesus was trying to tell you that he's not the Christ. Okay, because there's no point in it, because he's trying to tell you the guys are all children of God. But what happens is, because you're worshiping the idol, you've sold your birthright for the golden calf, which is the Christ idol. You've ignored God, replaced God with the golden calf, thinking that, oh, I have Christ in me. No, you're supposed to have God's spirit in you. And that's what I'm trying to show you, because God pours out his spirit. Remember Joel 2:28? Okay, it doesn't say Christ's spirit, it says God's spirit. Okay, and this is fulfilled as we speak right now. Acts 2:17. Now look at those numbers carefully. 2:17. Okay, Joel 2:28. August 2nd. are you guys seeing it now? 8th month, 2nd day, 8:2, 2:8. Right? Joel 2:28. Acts 2:17, the exact same verse, but one was taken in the beginning and the second one is after, saying that this is when God's here. Because that's what Jesus was trying to tell you guys. He was trying to warn you that God is returning. This is why he's telling you in Matthew 5:8, you know, 5 plus 8 is 13, as in Jason the 13th, right? You know, blessed are the pure in heart, they shall see God. Okay? So you're actually going to see him, is what Jesus is trying to tell you. That's why he's trying to say, I go now to prepare a place for you, for my Father's house has many mansions, he's trying to tell you. Okay, that house is the house of Jason. Okay, because Jason was a high priest in Israel, okay, in 17:5 BC. Now look at that number, house of Jason, 17. Verse 5. I'll show it to you. I you know what I mean? It's like high school all over again, you know? See, I was really quick at high school, right? While the simple-minded kids would be yapping all over, you know, and talking, being horsing around all the time, I had my work done already handed in by the time the class was over. Because you know how, you know, you go to high school, the teacher has to repeat themselves over for the slow ones, right? So I always had my work done immediately. So the only problem that the teachers said that I always had was I would be skipping class. Well, because I had my work done that day when it was assigned, right? over the out of the next 3 or 4 days, right? Usually the teacher repeats themselves in order to get the slow kids, you know, to, you know, catch up the work, right? So in that time, instead of me being at school, hearing the same thing over again, right? I would go spend my time somewhere else. So then I go back to school, see with another assignment, and I get it done. So at the end of the year, what they would do to my mark was, oh, because Jason, you have missed this amount of days, so we're gonna have to deduct your marks. And I'm like, that's not fair. Why do I have to be burdened, right? Sitting in class, having to hear the same spiel that you're telling to the teacher or to the slow ones. And I've already had my den work. I'm waiting for a new assignment. You know what I mean? So, but that was my struggle. That was the fight I always had. And it's the same thing today. I finished my work. I show you what I do every day, right? I've been doing this since I was 7 years old. From the day I went to, I'll even show you the, all right, okay. Google Earth. I'll even show you, I grew up in Outlook, okay? I'll even show you the church that I attended as a kid. This is where, I wasn't really into the Christian doctrine. I didn't care for it, okay? Because I knew better, right? Because you don't have to be a Christian to be a good person, guys, okay? You have to be a fool in order to indoctrinate yourself into men's doctrine. God released everybody in the beginning. Everyone's free. This is why we have free will. Do you not get that? Right? Your choice is to understand who God is in the Old Testament. That's listening to his voice. And that's what I've been trying to show you. Okay? It's not to sit there and, you know, preach the devil Paul's gospel. Right? That's Paul's gospel. The one thing that Christians don't understand is Paul corrupted the church. Okay? How he did it was he took away the commandments. But the commandments still stand. Right? That's what people don't understand. There's difference between God's law and men's traditions. Jesus is trying to tell you to stay away from men's traditions because they're not worth anything. Right? When you hear God's voice throughout the Old Testament, that is the hidden path that not many find. Because people are so focused in understanding what men are saying that they fell for the delusion, which is men's opinions. Oh. So, anyways. So this is in my before, you know, the colonists arrived in North America here, right? This was referred to as Turtle Island. It still is by my people, right? So down in here, right here, the Ten Commandments are located between Albuquerque and Las Lunas, New Mexico. I thought I'd show you this. Wherever Las Lunas is. Right here. See, right here. See, this river that goes by here, right? The Rio Grande, right? It was a mighty river at one time. But as you see, they're drying up. But in this area here, I think it's right here. Oh, no, right here. It's by a river anyways. Yeah, see, they have it recorded now. See? Right here, this is where, this is Hidden Mountain, okay? Do you see that? You guys can see that yourself, right? Hidden Mountain? See, Isaiah 65:11, it tells you, for those that forget, those that forget my holy mountain, right? Prepare a drink offering unto that number, okay? And what people don't seem to understand is that drink offering is a trap because, Jesus was trying to warn people. They weren't listening to Jesus. None of them were. Because he kept repeating themselves, saying, I'm not Christ, I'm not Christ, I'm not Christ. Right? He says that 3 times to the disciples. But Peter kept insisting, you are the Christ. Okay? And because men are listening to that delusion of what Peter, Paul, and all them are saying, they have forgotten what Jesus is telling them. This is why you guys don't know where the Father, where Jesus went. He went back to the Father. Like that's what he said when he was on the cross. Into thy hands I commend my spirit. So this is where Jason comes in because that's where his spirit went. It's a transformation. All right? See, people are see, this is what I've been starting to lead people to. I started discovering this way back in 2005. I think maybe earlier than that, you know, in Google Earth. I can't remember the exact year. But I discovered this area a long time ago. Okay? And this is what I've been trying to lead people to, the actual commandments. Because in the Bible, it records God moves mountains. So the fake Israel that we see in the Middle East, where Egypt is, they haven't left Egypt. They're still in Egypt. This is what they don't understand. They're claiming a land that doesn't belong to them. This is what they don't understand. The Jews do not understand that there's 12 tribes. Okay? These 12 tribes have to be brought together. Not just the Jew tribe, one tribe. Where's the other 11? Do you see what I mean? The other 11 is the one where God gathers them. This is why we have Ezekiel 34:11. 7:11. Jason, July, August, September, October, November. These things just don't magically fit into place like that. I'm trying to show you what the actual Spirit of God is. But you see everyone on YouTube, I have the Spirit, I have the Spirit, I have the Spirit. No, in the Bible it records no one has the Spirit because God has not released it yet. Just because men say this and this doesn't mean anything. If you guys haven't figured it out, when everyone has the Holy Spirit, it becomes into one household. That's what the Pentecost is. That hasn't happened yet. We're entering into that stage. This is referred to in the Bible as the birthing, right? What's being birthed is enlightenment, human enlightenment. It's like the law is returning because the law is the light. Okay, that's what makes people Israelites. Okay, just because these false Christians are sitting there, oh, I have the light, I have the light, doesn't mean shit. The law is the light. Proverbs 6:23. So that is what the light is, and the light is what Jesus kept. Do you guys understand? Right? So this is where the Ten Commandments is located, the Paleo-Hebrew. And what people don't understand about North America here, there's hidden objects here that people are disregarding, especially the Jewish clowns, because they don't seem to get it. They don't want to get it, because if they were to be proven wrong, that shambles their whole doctrine. And everything just gets thrown in dark garbage. But it already is, because God is the one that steps down on earth, because earth is his footstool. God, that happened. Revelation 21, verse 2. Or 21, verse 1. Anyways, it's in verse 21, where God returns to the earth. That's why Matthew 5:8 tells you that blessed are the pure in heart, they shall see God. So if you're making all these lies up, you're not pure of heart. You're just making stuff up because you're assuming this, you're assuming that and this, because based on what men are saying about this rapture. Do you guys not understand? I've been trying to help since day one. Even the Revelation 12 sign I created with Stellarium way back in 2005. I was the one pushing this stuff out. I'm still doing it, making little memes, but they don't want to listen. So this is where the Decalogue stove is, right? Right in this area here. Right? If you notice, this area here is a flat top. This is like a holdout. Okay? See, this is where ancient Jerusalem once stood. See, I think something was here before. If you notice something here, it looks like a structure. Right? See, something was here before. And this is the Rio Grande River, right? It was massive one time, right? But if armies were against you, you want to be up high, right? So this is what this is like a holdout position, right? But yeah, this is the where the Bible was getting, which is going to be fulfilled. okay, where God moves mountains from the fake Israel that's in the Middle East and back to its original place. That's how God moves mountains, by showing you what the actual truth is. That's why it's here. This is being fulfilled right now. Isaiah 65:11 or 11:11. Right? So I've been trying to lead people to this place here, right? This is Navajo land, right? And what they don't understand is the Native American people are part of the 12 tribes of Israel, okay? But nobody wants to talk about Native American and the history and all that. They just don't care, right? That's why we're called the hidden people, right? Nobody wants to see us. Right, so anyways, I'll go where I grew up. And look, I grew up in Dunblane too as a little boy, right? And there was a giant stone there where Lake Diefenbaker once stood. I'll show you where it was. Right here. See this? When the pioneers came here and the settlers came here, right, they were having droughts and all that. So what they did is they dammed this up here. Right? This is in Saskatchewan. Okay. And I grew up down in this area, Dunblane, right here. See, it's marked now because I've been leaving things here as I go. So this area, this lake here was never here before. This is a very sacred area to my people. Okay? Because there was caves here. This is where our we would camp out in the winter times. Right? The tribes from, let's say, the Cree from the north, right? The Blackfoot from the east, right? And then from the south, the Dakota, okay? And my people. This is where the gathering place was, in this area, very sacred area, right? From all these tribes, right? And there are supposedly, there are graves around here somewhere, right? That they discovered, right? And they have all this evidence here. There was a story that one of these people that I was doing this research on in this area, right, back in my younger years, university years, I was doing research on it, and they're saying that there was these sacred scrolls that my people have, that they were buried. So when the settlers came, right, in this area here, right, they had to hide them. So those are those sacred scrolls that document the history of the land. So what I think what they did was they dammed this area up specifically, right? Because they couldn't locate that information. Because if they located that information, this would give them title to this area. This is why I think they dammed this up and they took control of it, because this is referred to, this area here, as the jewel of Saskatchewan, right? When they don't realize that if Native people start establishing their rights again, if they go to court, we could win this land back again, right? So this is where I grew up in Dunblane as a little boy, okay? I went to school Lucky Lake, right? And then eventually we moved up into Saskatoon, right? Right in this area here, okay? But in the middle of here, see this area here, it's called, there's a place here I lived in Outlook, right? Along the river from right here, up all the way up here, right? I spent most of my time down by the river in Outlook. This is where I grew up, in Outlook, Saskatchewan, okay? Right, so I used to be down by the river here all the time. Every summer I was down here, collecting golf balls at the golf course here. I'd sell buckets full, right? And I had my money there and cans and all that. So that was my kid. It was like it was the greatest childhood, right? And the church I attended was Outlook Alliance. It was right here, right? This is the church I attended. Right? And here's the school right here. So another interesting note when I was a kid is that the Catholic priests were always interested in me. I never knew why, right? I think it began one day because, like I said, I've always had questions when it came to biblical stuff when I was a boy, okay? And his place was right here. See, this? There's the building of the, I don't know, I think it's a rectory or something where the Catholics hide. But anyways, his house was right here, right? And when I was a boy, when I was in church here, right? I think I started about eight or nine years old. I can't really remember. But it was pretty quick. Anyways, I was about 8 or 9. So my aunt, when she started going to the church, she was hired to clean the church. So I was always cleaning the church, you know, with her, right? And the pastor at that time was Tim Brazo, okay? And there was a group called Awanas, Approved Workmen Are Not Ashamed, where you get a, like a Boy Scout uniform, right? And you're taught to memorize the scripture, right? So how I started learned was how you see it when I present it to you like this. This is how I've always kept track of it, okay? This is how I used to memorize it, right? So there's one of the verses that's written in Isaiah, right? 56:10, I think, or 65:10. Anyways, 56:10, I think. Isaiah 56:10 says, declaring the end from the beginning. Okay, so this is what the pastors and these people don't seem to understand. Because right now, because I've been trying to flood the internet with the truth, right? These pastors now are in a panic mode, right? So they're telling their parishioners, right? Oh, you have to declare it. You gotta go from verse by verse now. You see, that's what they're doing. What they don't seem to understand is, right? God, Jesus gave a clue in how to understand the Bible. Okay, he said there's a path that not many find, okay, and it flows like the river, okay. So I've been trying to express that. See, God's voice is like a river, because it's water, right? Like my name is Camp Water, so it has to be declared from the end to the beginning, from the beginning to the end, like that. So we understand that a river, it doesn't flow straight. Have you ever seen a river flow straight? No, it goes this way and it goes that way and it goes this way, right? So that's how the Bible should be understood. There's patterns, there's sequences to this, and these sequences are numbers, and these numbers clearly identify which way to go, right? It's like a trail, right? It's like the numbers are like breadcrumbs, right? And when you understand those patterns, like for instance 7-Eleven, right? So that's like the biggest pattern, because it starts with the windows of heaven. And then the windows of heaven, the floodgates were opened, you know, and it's sort of sake. And that's 7-2, that's Revelation 7-2, the seal of God. And that's how you understand what the Bible is. Everything that's in the Bible, like men's opinions that's in there, it's all garbage, right? That's what you have to overcome. You have to overcome men's opinions, because Jesus was trying to give you a clue, right? He was trying to tell you, because, you know, here's the devil, you know, his devil, that what he ran into was Paul. See, I assume Paul was Jesus' father, because we don't know who Jesus' father is. But we have record that Mary, right, was confronted by an angel, right? And it's the only account where Mary was with another man, and then she suddenly got pregnant. So if we put two and two together, you begin to realize, like, you just don't make babies just because you're just out of thin air, right? That's what I mean. So I assume that was Paul, or Saul, his name was, right? Who impregnated Mary and told him all this garbage, right? Because we notice throughout the whole Bible, so Jesus this, Jesus Christ is like this. He's, and it even makes a mention in Corinthians, I think, where he, I think it's Corinthians 14:15 or 15:14. Second, think like that? Anyways. He makes mention that this is my son, or this is I've begotten you through the gospel, right? Which is basically, he's establishing, well, because of the gospel, you know, he killed his own son, right? Which is basically the story, which is another story of Isaac, right? Where he sacrificed his own son in order for him to be saved. But in the beginning of the Bible, right, it wasn't, Isaac was spared. Okay, who spared him? It was God himself as the sacrifice, because it was God who paid for the commandments with his own sacrifice. This is what people don't understand. Okay, and what people don't understand is that you cannot kill a man for salvation. It's impossible, because God left clauses in the Bible. 2 Kings 24:4. He says God will not pardon those that shed innocent blood. So it's throughout the Bible. And you wonder why God's angry, because nobody's listening to God throughout the Bible. Nobody's listening to his commands. Everyone's ignoring them. We see this going on right now today. They're following for the lies of men. Right? And that's what I'm trying to share. So, but that's what I've been trying to get people to understand. Right? So, right where the school is, right, like elementary school, this is where we spent most of our my childhood. There used to be a giant hill here, right? And I think there was a fire here. I don't remember at the gymnasium. I think there was. I just can't remember. And then here there used to be, wheels, right? They go around. And oh, look, they have the steering wheels. So you could just twist it and it would spin, right? I don't know how many times I've seen kids fly off that. But those are good times. And then I remember this one day. I think it was in grade 4. There was this, my friend, his name was Corey Ziegler, right? And one other kid was horsing around with a baseball bat, and he smacked him over the head. I witnessed that. I was right there. And there's this scene, blood just gushed out of his head. He's okay now, but I think he suffered some damage, right? And, but it looks pretty desolate than how it looks. This looked green before. Right, highly green. Now it just looks like it's just dry and parched. But this is where my childhood was. I didn't make it to high school because we moved to Saskatoon, right? And I was looking forward to high school. So anyways, my aunt had a friend. There's a care home right here, okay? And her name was Alice, and she lived in Dunblane with my aunt, so they were best friends. So what I used to do is part of the Awana's program was to go out in the community and help people, right? And what I used to do is I used to go to this place here, go visit, Alice, right? And she always welcomed me in, had cookies and all this, right? And I used to go read the Bible to certain people there, right? That's what I was supposed to do. I've been doing this since I was a boy, guys, right? And then it wasn't until we moved to Saskatoon is when I started exposed I was sponsored by my cousin to go to Bible camps. So I started going to Bible camps at a young age, and I kept going. And these Bible camps in Saskatchewan are very, how should I say it? They're just not from everyone from Saskatchewan. These kids are from all over North America. Okay. So it was pretty, I guess I wouldn't say elite, so to speak, but it was a pretty specific. It wasn't word of mouth sort of deal, right? It was only those that were selected in order to pick up these things, and I was, right, because of my devotion to the Word of God, okay, and because I was selected even by the churches, because of how hard I worked and how hard my I just love the Word of God, basically. I still do. So I've been doing this since I was a boy. And I was led to all these things today because I knew from when I was, I think it was 9 or 10, is when I read Exodus 20:20. So if you're a kid and you're bored one day and you do the numbers and you look in the future, you can actually see that's coming. So I knew Exodus 20:20 was coming in the year 2020. Like, God's coming to prove. That was one of the straight verses I've kept. It kept me on the straight and narrow, with the Word. Right? That's what faith is. Faith is hearing God's voice, which is in the Bible, and sticking with it. You're going to hear a lot of these false teachers talk, well, I have faith. They don't have shit. If they're stuck in Paul's words, they don't have faith. If they're stuck in men's opinions, right, they don't have the Holy Spirit. Just because men say this and this in the Old Testament, in Acts and wherever in the Old Testament, saying, oh, I have the Holy Spirit, they don't. Because if God declares it in the Old Testament saying they're not going to have my spirit, they're going to have this Christ spirit, you know, the idol, right? Then they're not going to understand things. That's why we're in chaos, because once you have the Holy Spirit, once you have everyone has come into the same house, which is the house of Jason, right? Well, then you begin to understand that's where the Spirit comes from, right? And I'm trying to show them that. And then once they understand the pattern, that's when they have the Holy Spirit. But that hasn't happened yet, because they're all being ignorant, which has been prophesied. Even God's telling them in the Old Testament. That's why he's angry, because nobody's listening. Everyone's gone their own way, right? Because you have to remember, in Genesis 6:3, it tells you, my spirit shall not strive with man, for his days will be 120 years, right? So God's spirit has left, okay, till God returns, okay, which is happening right now, right, and pours out his spirit, okay? So, see, people don't know what that spirit is. See, that spirit is written an account in John or Matthew 3:16, right? And then the Spirit of God descended like a dove, and lightning was upon him. So you're going to look two keywords in there, lightning and dove. Okay, dove is a bird. Okay, lightning is associated with thunder, thunderbird. Now, if you look at North America here, this is why nobody knows anything about North America. Okay, you guys, you know, I know I'm kind of hard with people, but they just don't want to listen. That was my ancestors who taught the Hebrews long ago until they were kidnapped and taken away to the Middle East. Because you have to remember, Nebuchadnezzar came and kidnapped a bunch of people and took them back to the Middle East, right? And some survived, because we hear this account in Jeremiah. And Jeremiah also talks about, the Ark of the Covenant, right? Those two tablets were found in Newark, Ohio. Okay, those two stones were in the Ark of the Covenant. Those are the two holy stones. Okay, they're found in a museum in Newark, Ohio. Okay, I've been trying to direct people to those stones. Okay, they have ancient Paleo-Hebrew on them. It's not modern Hebrew like the ones in Israel right now. Right? And another thing about Israel. Israel is not a country. It's a spirit. Okay? A spirit, right, is what we're supposed to understand, not to believe in a country. See, that's the deception. That's the delusion. Right? And that Israel... Once you understand what Israel is, you begin to realize it's God's law, his voice. And then once you understand that, that's where you get the title Israelite. Do you understand that? That doesn't happen. Okay? See, what people don't seem to get, you know, the Jews don't seem to understand, it's not about their traditions. God doesn't give a shit about the Jewish traditions, because God created man in his image, not in a Jewish image. That's their fault. But today you're going to notice people saying, oh, if you talk bad of the Jews, it's anti-Semite. But what people don't seem to understand is it's the Jewish people that are causing this problem throughout the world. Okay? They're bullying the Palestinians when the Palestinians, Hamas, are just, they know that God is God, and that's what you need to understand. There is no Messiah. There's no Christ. There's just God. Only one Lord God. That one Lord God is the people united. Do you understand? Then you begin to understand God. See? Because it's about God's spirit. God's spirit has to dwell in everybody. And that's what I'm trying to show you and give you. That's why I'm showing you my spirit. My spirit name. Okay? My Anishinaabek spirit name is Kwepeo Teotambanese. First Thunderbird flies west praying. That's my name. That was a name given to me when I was 4 days old, just an infant. Okay? This is why I have a strong connection to understand how this Bible works. Because when I was in Outlook, there was this, I was 7 years old. It was, must have been during the summer. Okay, here's the main street. Right, so there's a little building here. I'm going to show you. Oh, the Outlook Bakery. I used to go there, and I used to have, oh, Franklin Street. Okay, this is where my childhood was. There's a little bookstore here. Somewhere around here. Right there. Hold on. I gotta go this way here a bit. Right here. This is the bookstore. It's closed now. Right? This is the bookstore right here. This white building. Right here. I'll try and zoom in here. Yeah. This was, there used to be a bookstore here. This is the bookstore when I was 7 years old, right? My aunt must have went to the bookstore. I don't know why she went into the bookstore, okay? But it was here. So we walked in. The counter was on this side, okay? The lady was on this side, okay? And then it must have been early in the morning. You know, the sun was beaming through this window here, and I could see it. It reflected right through. And then on this side, there was a book. There was like a book, like there. This is a bookstore. The bookstore is everywhere. Right? So the sun was beaming right through here. It cut through. You could see the dust particles. It cut right through it. Right? That's what the sun does. So what I noticed was this red book. And it looked like it was glowing because it was shining right on top of it. Right? And that's what I was led to. And that red book, it happened to be a red King James picture Bible. My family still has it. It's ragged all that, because I read it every day. I was so fascinated. But before, when I bought it, we weren't Christians. Okay? I just happened to look like it because it was a picture book. It was a picture Bible. When I started reading it, okay, the very first, as soon as I got out of the bookstore, okay, out of the bookstore, my aunt was parked over here, okay, and I came around here, and I opened it up. And the very first verse I read, ever read, was Revelations 20, verse 15. And I'm never going to forget that verse, because it hit me. As a kid, when you read something of that magnitude, you don't know what to make of it. Okay? All I understood was how it was read. And that's how I read the Bible, how it was read. I don't interpret. That's the most dangerous thing to do. To say, take this word out of here and change it this, change this. Like, what right do you people have to take God's word, twist it all up, and make something out of it? Like, Revelation 20, verse 15 tells you, whosoever's name not found in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. I'm never going to forget that verse. So, it was after that point, I spent day and night looking for my name. But at the same time, you're reading all these stories and all that, becoming well-versed, right? And it wasn't probably about maybe 5-6 months, maybe a year. I'm not exactly sure. We started going to the church. But before then, I was going to all these different churches, trying to find answers, I had questions. But nobody could ever answer my questions. Except they would always, the Christians, all they would do is, do you know Jesus Christ? And I said, yeah, I know. But he's in my mind, because I've already known that he wasn't Jesus Christ. Do you know what I mean? It's like, how do you tell someone that their beliefs are wrong? That's the whole Christian foundation. They don't understand. It was already been corrupted. Right? What they don't understand is that when Jesus said to Peter, he says, upon this rock, what rock do you think he's talking about? Rock and roll? He's talking about the commandments. this rock I build my church on. That's the commandments. That's Jesus' church was founded on the commandments. But when Paul came along, he says, you don't need the commandments anymore. We killed Jesus. We got rid of him. Now your sins are forgiven. And that is what they tried to preach to me. And I said, no, you cannot break God's law. This is what I'm thinking in my mind. I'm saying, you cannot break God's law just because men say this and that. See, I already had knowledge already. And this is why I'm just wondering, I'm like, if as a kid as me, understanding this information prior to why these pastors are talking like this, not realizing that Paul is actually the devil. Because you have to remember 2 Kings 24:4, which is associated with Matthew 24, which is next year. Next year is 2024. 24, 24, anything throughout the Bible is 24. It's associated with that year. That's why it says only the Father knows the day and hour. And if they understood what Jesus is telling, and if they actually believed what Jesus is saying, they wouldn't be following Paul. Do you see what I mean? You would be going back to the Old Testament as where Jesus is trying to lead you to. He first thing that Jesus tells you, give up everything on the cross. Just empty your cup. Because right now, everybody's cups is full. It's all full of bullshit. You have no room for God. And that's why I'm wondering, it's like, if God comes up back on the earth, if Jesus comes back on the earth, they're not going to even recognize him. Right? But that's the transition process. This is what they don't seem to understand. So, I thought I'd throw that in there as quick as I can. So, I'm going to show you some work that I've been doing. Oh yeah, in my last video, I take pictures. This is my, a couple days ago, I took some, I went and got some gas, right? And, this is what it came up to, right? 7-11. 5 + 2 is what? 7, right? 3 + 8 is what? 11. 7-11. 3 + 4 is 7, right? 7-7, right? And then 3 + 5 is 8. Okay, which is 19. This is 11. And then plus this is 8. 8 plus 11 is what? 19. Right? 14, 11. Or 14, 19. Okay? Or 5, 20. Or 5, 2. Right? 7. So I thought I'd show you that in there. Oh yeah, then I show you the... Alright, I'm going to show you something here. As you know, I'm in disability, you know, and, you know, the Isaiah 9:6 tells you, right? It tells you, Isaiah 7:14, right? It tells you, right? The Lord himself shall show you a sign. Okay, so this is my November benefit. Okay, for my disability benefit, right? 23:10:30. 10:30 is John 10:30. Okay, I and my Father are one. 3:23. But anyways, I didn't want to look into those numbers, but look at these numbers. 9 + 2 is what? 2 + 9 is 11, right? 7, 5. 12, 3, 11. This is 3:11. Ecclesiastes 3:11. Or 3:2. Or 23. Flip it around, right? But yeah, that's what it says in Isaiah 9:6. It tells you the government will be on his shoulders. Yeah, because I'm in disability, right? Because of my kidney failure, right? I'm trying to show you the holy arm of the Lord, right? My dialysis arm, two needles go in my arm, right? He'll be pierced, right? Zechariah 12:10, right? And his blood, there are two blood. There's two blood sacrifices. One's God's, where God does it willingly. The second is where you're being murdered, where Jesus is being murdered. That's the wrath of God. There's two different bloods in the sacrifices. But instead, what happens is the Christians come along, and because they lack understanding, they twist it all up and they just, oh, Jesus, this, Jesus, this, Jesus. There's two people throughout the Bible. These are the two witnesses, Jason and Jesus. Okay? And then God's Spirit dwells upon him. That's how that works. Right? And that they pour out, but they didn't listen to Jesus in the beginning, so he was killed. Okay? So this is the second time. Right? And the dragon is the year of the dragon, which is next year, 2024. It's the Chinese year of the dragon. This is what people are not seeing. Right? But it's where it's coming to an end, because the truth, I'm pouring it out as what I'm instructed to do. Right? These two stones are Jesus and Jason, jasper and sardine, which, if you notice in the Bible, it talks about a pipe. Okay? That's the sacred pipe. This pipe, okay, I was granted it back in, I think it was like, actually a year before my son Keenan was born. And he's 14 right now. So 15 years I was given the sacred pipe. I still have it. Right? See, my grandfather had 7 pipes. Okay? The other ones were sold, or my dad and my uncle did something to them. But one was left, and I have it. See, this is where the peace comes in from, because they're called peace pipes. Okay? This is the beginning when I gather the people. This is what we're going to smoke, because the Lord's house is full of smoke. If people understand what the Bible talks about, it doesn't mean we're inhaling it. It's symbolizing to peace. Okay? This is all recorded in the Bible. That pipe is called, it's a jasper stone, which is exactly as you see right here. Jasper. See? That's called redstone because it's called redstone because of the blood of the ancestors, the people that died here during the colonial wars, right? Or to the Indian wars, right? War of 1800s, I should say, which is just coming to an end of the 100 years war, right? But yeah, that's what I mean. That's, black people are going to associate this with themselves, because I've already seen it. They don't look like they're jasper or redstone, right? This is referring to the red man, to the Native American person. That's what these stones symbolize. Okay? I'm just trying to show you this, these guys. Hey, that's all I'm trying to do, is help you. See, my rent. See, I'm in a low-cost house. This is my rent. See, December 1st, 2023, November 30th, 2024. So this is my what I pay for the following year. 761, or 6 plus 1 is 7. 77. What is my rent here? It's 711. As in Jason. July, August, September, October. Right? 3 plus 5 is 8. 1 plus 5 is 6. 8, 6. 8, 6 throughout the Bible happens to connect to every verse too. Right? So I thought I'd show you that. That's, you know, that's where the fulfillment of Isaiah 9:6 comes from. The government will be on his shoulders. Yeah, because I'm in disability. See, on my CPP benefit, right? That's what I'm... what I've been on. So anyways, it gets even... like, it's like this every day. Even I go to Tim Hortons. Every time I go to Tim Hortons, it's every number that I look at, my receipt, it's always the same. 1070, which is, you know, 10-7, which is the, what just happened, right? So that's why I get these warnings from. This is how I looked at my Bible right away. See, 34-38. That's 7-11, guys. Even the Apple is telling me. All right, so even here, look, I'm just showing just parts, but it's like this for me every day. See, my Master Chief there, and there's my birth date exactly, 802. Looking at this number, 27, or 117, Master Chief. I'm just like, whoa, this is blown away. This has been going on since I was a kid, guys. All right. I've been seeing these things since I was a boy. All right. And 8/2 is August 2nd, my birth year, my birth month. Master Chief, we all know 117, right? Which is associated with Microsoft. And this number, see, I had a Buick LeSabre prior to my Dodge Dakota now, right? Right? Before I sold it, that day I took this picture. Okay? Because I knew this was coming. Let me tell you, I just didn't sit there all day and wait for 10:07. I just jumped in my car, right? You know, got everything ready, you know, and made sure everything's okay. What was wrong with it was that the steering rack was leaking, right? And I just didn't have time to fix it and all that stuff, so I just got rid of it. So I decided to, well, I'm going to turn it on, and I turned it on, and I took this picture. Not knowing until after seeing the picture, looking through my pictures, I'm like, 10/7, January 2023. I was like, whoa. So anyways, that's January 1st, 28. See the number 28? See, I don't plan these days. It just happened to be, right? Because I'm always led. So this is Revelation 10:7, where the seventh angel's voice speaks, right? Which happened, and I'm trying to warn people that destruction was coming, or there was something coming to Israel. Israel's armies will be surrounded, and their houses are going to be ravaged and all that. I was trying to warn people, but nobody was listening to me, right? And I was trying to get the words. I was talking to the Jews. I was warning them this was coming. Do you think they were listening? They didn't give a shit what I was saying. That's why these things are happening. It's being fulfilled, guys. Because they've disobeyed God's words, I'm trying to show them, that's why these things are happening. And it's just going to get worse for them. It's already beginning to worse for them because they're disobeying what I'm trying to say. I've been trying to help them. See, this is the stuff I've been working on. Idolatry, because everyone's in idolatry. They don't know it. Oh, look at that. Even 226. I didn't even notice that. You know that building there? It's 226. Right? 222 Franklin Street. So I'm sure if you look in the Bible for it, 22 verse 6, let's check it out. Let's check it out here. Revelations. I'm showing you how I've been doing this since I was a boy. So this is how I know the Bible, because I would see the numbers. I'll just close that. Okay. And he said unto me, these sayings are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent this angel to show unto his servants the things must shortly be done. Yeah, see, I've known, I don't know if I remember that now, but now you could actually see what's actually, how it fits. So what I wanted to show you here, because I know these, I've been posting things, right? And my little, I don't know what to call them, picture things. But this is what I've been trying to express. It's about the voice of God. That's it. Everything else in the Bible is just men's opinions. It's bullshit. That's what you have to overcome. I've been trying to tell you. It doesn't matter what's happening in the world. It has nothing to do with the Israel. It has nothing to do with these things happening all over. Everything that's in the Bible must stay in the Bible, guys. Right? In order to have faith, well, you have to speak God's word. That's what Jeremiah 23:28 tells you. It tells you those that have faith will speak my words, which is the voice of God. But if you don't, that's the chaff, which will be thrown in the fire. Which is like Paul's words, men's opinions, or what they say or what they think. Totally forgetting God. That's the whole point. That's the whole message. Right? Because there is no Christ. There is just the Lord. Our God is one Lord. That's it. There is no Christ. There is no Messiah. God is the one that comes and saves. This is my spirit name. Right? This was taken, right? Google, January 6, 2020. Okay, that's the first month. Second or sixth day, which is, you know, Trump's inauguration when he was voted in, right? And that's exactly the same day that, the White House was bombarded. I think it was 2021 or 22. Anyways, one of those days. That's when they were, you know, it's always in the news. But that happened January 6th. I was trying to warn that was coming because of Matthew 16:20, which is he charged his disciples to tell no man that he was Jesus the Christ. That is what you have to believe. You know, I've been trying to tell people this is, no one believes Jesus. They don't, because Jesus is trying to tell you. He's trying to tell you, he's expressing, he's like, how many times have you been crying because his disciples weren't listening to him? You could just see the frustration in Jesus's tone when you're hearing him speak, because nobody's paying attention to him. That's been fulfilled. I showed you in one of my videos that his disciples just walked away from him. All the people walked away from him. That's what's going on right now. They don't care to hear about Jesus anymore, right? They talk about it. Oh, Jesus, this Jesus, yo, Jesus. But they don't. That's why Jesus said that from the Old Testament. They speak. They praise me with their lips, but their heart is farther from me. Okay? Jesus spoke those words, which is from the Old Testament. Right? Because you all have denied him already. But anyways, this the enormous bird, he symbolizes great power and strength, right? This is considered the Thunderbird, right? Which is, you guys would consider the Holy Spirit, you know, the dove. This is what that is. It's the Thunderbird, right? Okay, Isaiah 45:6. They may know from the rising of the sun and from the west, I'm in the west, that there is none beside me. I am the Lord and there is none else. Isaiah 59:19. So they shall fear the name of the Lord of the West, and his glory from the rising sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood. The Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. That's what I've been trying to do. The Spirit of God descending like a dove. Right, this is a metaphor here, like a dove. Every time you see that, like a is a dove. It's not an actual dove. It's a metaphor symbolizing a bird. Right? What type of bird? Lightning upon him. So lightning was associated with thunder. Okay? So there's associated verses to go with that, which is Zechariah 14:9 and 9:14, right? Where it talks about the Lord is lightning and all that, which is associated with this. So you're going to notice some Bibles, they changed it to lightning with an E. That was a mistake. That was an error. It's lightning, because throughout the Old Testament, it's all lightning. It's not a lighting. It's because it's associated with this one again, which is confirming that, which is, for as lightning comes out of the east, which was Jesus, and shines even unto the west, which is Jason. Right? 24 is what? 2 plus 4 is 6. 2 plus 7 is what? 9. 6, 9. From the 6th hour to the 9th hour, right? I'm in dialysis at 6 p.m. till 9 p.m. Yeah, see, there's my name there. right? Camp Waters, right? EAU for water. Look, I'll even show you that yourself. The French word for water. Like, I don't understand. Like, you guys, there's some very smart people up, but they just don't want to do the research on the name Jason. I'm like, it's there. Okay, water in French. Water is EAU. Because I'm trying to tell you, part of King David's line, right, immigrated to North America. And that Campo name is a French name, which is associated with the line of King David from the French side. And because I have sovereignty in North America, I have a treaty card, right, which you guys are all ignoring, breaking the covenant, you know what I mean, where I have a treaty with you, right, that we're all treaty people, and you guys are ignoring me. You know what I mean? But I'm trying to tell you, this is being fulfilled. This is why all the Christians are in a big rush right now, because it's talking in Revelation 2012 or 12:12, right? The devil has a short time, right? Which is coming close, because the end of the tribulation happens April 8th and it's over, because I have spoken my truth. It's all been exposed. And even when I'm gone, that information I'm leaving on the internet is going to be eternal, because data is eternal. It works the same way if you're lying on YouTube. This is why some will awake to everlasting life and some to everlasting shame, because the ones that are lying on YouTube, you know, the rapture cultists, when they realize their error, because it's going to happen, that's coming to be fulfillment, the weeping and gnashing of teeth. Some are going to weep because they'll realize their error and they'll just, oh, I'm sorry, you know. And then some will be like, oh, that can't be, man, and get angry. Right? And that's coming. I'm just trying to warn you guys. Right? And the reason why these things are happening, because people are ignoring what I'm saying. As a result, right, people are dying. And right at the beginning, I was trying to say, nobody needs to die. Nobody needs to kill nobody. Because I'm trying to tell where the Jews are supposed to go, where the Ten Commandments are. They should hear my voice and understand that's where the Paleo-Hebrew Commandments are. And if the Americans are working with the Jews, well, the Jews, they should come back to North America where they belong and build. And that's because that's where the stone is. They have every opportunity to go back there, because that's part of where they're supposed to be. That's where Moses led them to, right? And that's why the commandments were there. And because they followed into idolatry, you know, remember when Aaron created the golden calves, right? That's what caused their destruction. And this is why they got kidnapped. Oh my goodness. Holy smokes. I've been trying to get this story, because there's a story, a hidden story that nobody wants to know about. It all begins with Jason, the high priest, right? If you guys took some, just Google the name Jason, it's there. You're going to notice that his name was changed by Josephus to Jesus. They did that on a purpose as part of the delusion. They changed it from Jason, you know, the rightful name, to Jesus. It was the Jews that did that. Jason, Yeshua, or Jesus. See, the real name is Jason. High priest from 174 to 171 BC. Well, other places it's 175. So there's a whole story about who he was. I think Wikipedia has a different version. WikiWand. WikiWand. See, WikiWand says, let's see, 175 this time. But that's why we get House of Jason in Acts 17, verse 5. Oh, my neck and shoulders are aching. Oh, I've been doing this too long, guys. So I think I'm going to end it at that note here and maybe come back with a part two. Right. Jason, Hebrew, Yasin. Because the letter J didn't exist, not to the 17th century. Right? When they created the King James, the letter J didn't exist, so they didn't know what to do. They just put as a son. That's where we get a son of God from. His name was a son. There was no a son of God. There's just J son. Right? 17 or 175 BC or 17 verse 5, the house of Jason. Right? 171 or 117. Right? Or 711. Jesus, Joshua, Yeshua. Before he changed it. So, it was the Jewish people that changed it. See? Josephus records that is his name. That his name was originally Jesus. Or Joshua. Hebrew. Yeshua. Before he changed it. I'm trying to say this, but without having to say it. I'm just trying to show you what the Bible is trying to say. But none of you want to read what the Bible is. I was trying to show you how it was the Jews that changed the name. But then Jesus or Jason changed, slipped it back in there without their knowledge. Do you see? It went from, he changed it to Jesus as the deception to fool people. Because they didn't want to understand who Jason really was. Right? So they manipulated the scripture, the history. But it's all documented. It's all, the evidence is there. I'm here. I show you my first and last name. So anyways, I appreciate you all. I'm not here to harm people. I'm not here to cause arguments. I'm here to show you what the truth is. And it's all, you just gotta look, it's there. I'm not, why would I make this up? I'm just trying to tell you the truth. Okay? And I'm gonna do everything I can to help you. Okay? Because I love the Word of God. I've kept with it since I was 7 years old. So I'm 47 years old now. 40 years. So the 40 years of the time in the desert has come to its fruition. Do you understand? We're at the end. 2022 of Revelations is the end of the Bible. Right? From 2020, when God proves, Exodus 2020, Moses has said, for God is coming to prove you that you sin not, then COVID appeared. Everyone went into lockdown. Lockdown in Saskatchewan was 3/20, March 20th, my aunt's birthday. That is Revelations 3:20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. When you guys are waiting for Jesus to appear, he's not going to come in a physical form. He's coming in a spiritual form. He comes down from the clouds. You know what I mean? That's called the internet. I've been trying to show you who he is. I've been trying to show you what he's been saying. That is the fulfillment, because it's the Father that brings Jesus and glorifies him. And then Jesus glorifies him. You guys even know you read your Bible? Shit. Anyways, I thank you. I appreciate you guys all. I truly do. Nobody needs to die. But as long as you guys are ignoring my words, okay, more people are going to die. And as long as all these countries are supporting fake Israel, more people are going to die. The Jews need to repent. They need to repent of their religion and return back to God. Not Hashem. Whoever this Hashem is doesn't exist. There's just God and his name. And Josephus hid that name. You see the evidence right there. The Jews caused this deception. And they blinded everybody's eyes. Because everybody's in this Christ doctrine. Oh, Christ in me. Where's God's spirit? Oh, God's spirit is thrown in the garbage, in the trash, because we don't need it no more. That's why Jesus told you that in Mark 7:8. Right? For laying aside the commandment of God for the traditions of men. Look, for Pete's sake, Resurrection Day is coming. Mark 12:25. That's Resurrection Day. This is the time which I believe is coming up this Christmas, because that's Christmas Day. That's when you should come out of this, these traditions. And remember the commands, because the commands are the light. You're going to hear all these false teachers, oh, I have the light, or the light, or I have the light. They have no clue what the light is. The light is the commandments. So anyways, I appreciate you all. Oh, my back is sore. Thank you. And love the Lord your God with your heart, mind, and soul. And it comes to take away the law of the prophets. I came to fulfill. Okay? Take care and have a good day.